three stages are there. That is how they are going to be circulated in the form of data. So first one is data creation. Then data are created. How the data be created? It depends on situation. As an example, we know that our term test marks, match marks, science marks are defined as data or information. Data, how are they prepared? Are they just prepared automatically or the subject teacher is making that? Subject teacher is making that. Just like in the school. Assume that weather data to forecast the weather tomorrow. We want to collect the weather today. Then how can weather be weather data be collected now? Is the subject teacher prepared for the data? We may have sensors, temperature sensor. That will read the temperature. We may have a humidity sensor. They will read the humidity. Then by that time, sensors will create the data. Then we can't be fixed how the data are created. Somehow, depending on the situation, sensors, humans, some machine, some other detectors, they will create the data that are we use. Then after creating the data, next stage is data management. Again, we'll go back to the weather forecasting. In different places, there are sensors fixed. There are temperature sensors, sometimes the humidity sensor, then the pressure sensor. So, those are fixed. And all of them are sending data to the central weather server, to the network. Then, once they are generating the data creation, they will be sent to the server. Once they are connected to the server, is that creation of data or is that managing the data? Now data is received here. Temperature is this, humidity is this, pressure is this. Then inside the system, are the data created further or are the data handled inside the system? They are handled, managed. Is organization, system, they create the data that they want. Once the clear data exists, they will be sent to the particular system. Maybe server, maybe a computer, sometimes it may be a paper if it is not an ICT-based system. Then they are being managed. Under the data management, the processing, calculation, securing, protecting them, and backup. Backup is keeping a copy of the original data. Why do you keep copies? Keeping copy of the original data. Why is it? Why are they keeping copies? For the safety. If the original data are damaged, we can use them from the copy. But we don't have issues. That's another story. Then when you are going to keep backup, that's also going under data management, right? Why sometimes this data server may get crashed due to a technical failure. Due to writing, the whole system may get burnt out. Then what are the data loss? But if you copy them, some other system, we can get them back though the system is destroyed. Management means handling the data according to your perspective, according to your usage. Right. Then the next thing is, the third step is removal of obsolete data. Sir, now I am not having any connection with that specific bank. Then what happened to them? Should they keep my data further or they remove it? I don't have any connection to them. Now they are going for the removal of outdated data. Is that they have all the data from the server are removed or only my account data is coming? Only my data, they are the outdated obsolete data. So in that hand is here. Even the system applying the term is even your results and even the hospital. So any other place, the data handled, these three steps are circulating along with the data life cycle of the data. Data created, management, and then they are removing the unnecessary data. At the same time, a new data will get, they are managing and removing. So this is circulation.